A large black billboard with the message, "I love J.K. Rowling," was posted up in Vancouver over the weekend. Within 24 hours, the billboard had been vandalized with paint splattered all over it, and shortly after was taken down altogether. As you can imagine, the billboard sparked a debate, or a conversation, once again, regarding the remarks Rowling made months ago that some have labeled transphobic. A city councilor expressed her displeasure, which led to her receiving support and some hate for trying to censor another successful woman. There was also some international interest because of this one billboard, and I'm going to tell you guys all about it right now in Inform Overload. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to IO. I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and today we are once again talking about JK Rowling. Make sure to get comfortable and stick around to the end of this one for some comment replies for another video, but for now, let's get right into it. Now, for those of you who don't remember, Rowling faced a good amount of backlash following a handful of tweets which people felt were transphobic. Admitting to being a victim of domestic abuse in an essay slash blog post she would release after the backlash, Rowling's original tweets were cited in an article with the headline, I quote, "Creating a more equal post-COVID-19 world for people who menstruate." Rowling then tweeted out, I quote, "I'm sure there used to be a word for those people. Someone help me out. Wumbin? Wimpund? Womund?" She would go on to tweet, I quote, "If sex isn't real, there's no same-sex attraction. If sex isn't real, the lived reality of women globally is erased. I know and love trans people, but erasing the concept of sex removes the ability of many to meaningfully discuss their lives. It isn't hate to speak the truth. The idea that women like me, who have been empathetic to trans people for decades, feeling kinship because they're vulnerable in the same way as women, i.e. to male violence, hates trans people because they think sex is real and has lived consequences, is nonsense." Following her tweets, the LGBTQ+ community, as well as former Harry Potter stars, including Daniel Radcliffe, Emma Watson, and Rupert Grint, all spoke out against what Rowling said. Radcliffe said, I quote, "Transgender women are women. Any statement to the contrary erases the identity and dignity of transgender people and goes against all advice given by professional healthcare associations who have far more expertise on the subject matter than either Joe or I." Watson went on to say, "Trans people are who they say they are," while Grint said, "Trans women are women, trans men are men." Now, I'm not gonna stand here and say I know what Rowling meant or means by her comments, as I'm not her. That being said, she has claimed time and time again that she supports and believes in trans rights, but at the same time, at least from how I perceive her comments, that biologically you can't change your gender based on how you feel. Now again, this is how I understood what she said, so maybe she means something totally different. Either way, it seems she's not necessarily transphobic, or so she says, but instead wants to keep certain spaces safe for women who at times can feel vulnerable. However, she's not ignorant to the fact that trans people also feel vulnerable in the same way as women, which is why she capped her tweets off with the idea that she hates trans people because she thinks sex is real is nonsense. Now, to no surprise, there are extremists on both sides of the argument, as there seems to be the case with anything and everything nowadays. That's fine. But in Vancouver, Amy Hamm and Chris Elston decided to put some funds together to post a large billboard in support for Rowling. Hamm explained, I quote, "I don't think it's possible for women to defend their legal rights or even the definition of womanhood if anybody can say that they are a woman and it will be so. Women's rights are important and we need to stand up for them, and it's not transphobic to do so." Elston explained, "This is about safeguarding women's rights, safeguarding children. It's about free speech. J.K. Rowling has been canceled." On the flip side, Sarah Kirby Young, who's a part of the Vancouver City Council, condemned the billboard, tweeting out, I quote, "I'm condemning this clear, intentional messaging meant to stoke hate, exclusion, and division. This kind of hateful expression sets us all back, not moves us forward. Hope we see an outpouring of love, solidarity that drowns out the hate. Hashtag love not hate, hashtag take it down." As previously mentioned, within 24 hours, the billboard was splattered with paint, and the company, Pattison Outdoor, covered the billboard altogether, leading Kirby Young to tweet out, "At the end of the day, we are all just human beings. When one of us is diminished, all of us are diminished. Thank you at Pattison Outdoor for making the right decision." Kirby Young went on to say, "I think it's intentionally intended to incite hate without officially contravening guidelines of hate speech. But the clear intent is to stoke division and be exclusive of people in our city. It's clearly targeted, in my opinion, towards the trans community." And although it seems most people agreed with the city council member's stance, as you can imagine, a handful of people didn't. One person retweeted Kirby Young's tweet and captioned it, "Vancouver City Councilor celebrates the censorship of a billboard expressing affection for a successful female author." Another user from Ireland tweeted Chris, who paid for the original billboard, asking how they too can show support for Rowling. Chris replied, "Just give those sign companies a call. O'Connell Street would look great with a little JK love. We'll help." At the end of the day, it's quite possible those supporting JK Rowling's stance don't even see eye to eye with the author and are simply just using her stance to further push their own beliefs. As I said before, it doesn't seem that Rowling's comments were intentionally malicious, nor were they meant to disregard or offend the trans community. Again, I can't say for sure because I haven't had a conversation with her, and I won't stand here and just assume what she meant. And I don't know if those who posted the billboard are necessarily transphobic either, which is why I always encourage people to have a conversation and try to come to a mutual understanding of why they believe in what they do. At the end of the day, it's no secret that the trans community faces discrimination and deals with violence on a regular basis simply because of how they identify. And regardless of what you believe in, for or against, I think we can all agree that at the end of the day, all human beings have a right to express themselves and their beliefs without being subject to harassment. Now, as always, guys, I'd love to hear your thoughts on this one in the comments down below, so feel free to make your stance known. For now, let's reply to some comments from the video. Samsung developing fully transparent phone. Hello Kitty said, this is something a really strict parents would get for their child. Yeah, now that I think about it, yeah, they probably would. I'm a little uncomfortable though. You can't trust your own kid, which I get. Some kids you can't trust because they're just always up to no good, but it's when you get the Scooby-Doo and the gang to come and stop those shenanigans. Take off the mask. I would have gotten away with it. I don't know. Karma506Z said, can't wait to drop one. Yeah, well, what, with the back crack or the front? I guess it would be see-through, get it? All right, I'll go on to the next comment. James H said, Samsung will invent it, Apple will copy it, and Apple fans will say Samsung copied iPhone. It's funny, because you're not wrong, but you forgot to add the fact that Apple will just make Samsung's original feature way better, even though they didn't think of it. They always do. Anyways, guys, that's all for this one. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein, and we'll see you guys in the next one.